Hello students, now we are discussing, now I am explaining the concept of connection establishment in TCP using a network simulator. So first we will see what is a TCP. TCP is nothing but transmission control protocol, was especially designed to provide a reliable end-to-end byte stream over an unreliable internet network. Each machine supporting a TCP has a transport entity, either a user process or a part of the kernel that message TCP streams and interface to IP layer. It is an entity expects user data streams for local processes, breaks them up into pieces not existing 64 KB, and sends each piece as a separate IP datagram. Client server mechanism is necessary for TCP to behave properly. So TCP to timeout and transmit if needed. TCP connection is a duplex connection, that means there is a no difference between two sides once the connection is established. Basically, it is used the three-way handshake is the procedure used to establish a connection between TCP. This procedure normally is initiated by one TCP and responded by another TCP. The procedure also works of two TCP simultaneously, where each TCP receives a synchronization segment with carriers no acknowledgement after it has sent SYN. Of course, arrival of an old duplicate SYN segments can potentially make it appear. So the recipient that the simultaneous connection initiation is in progress, proper use of reset segments can distinguish these cases. So three-way handshake reduces the possibility false connection. It is the implementation of a trade-off between a memory and message to provide information for this checking. So in three-way handshake, first TCP is sending a request, then it sends a synchronization, responder receives the connection request and make it connection configuration with first TCP. Then first TCP receives, initiator receives the confirmation and make the establishment on with the responder and identify, and again it set back acknowledgement to the destination port plus the sequence numbers identify these connections. So along with this theoretical explanation, first we will see the setup of the network connection establishment for TCP. So using the end devices of this network simulator, first we take the desktop machines for PC0, PC1, PC2 and PC3. They are linked to the switch network devices and they are connected to one server PT. So after designing this network, we can set the addresses for all these devices. So first we will set the address for server. So click on server and select the desktop option, IP configuration, set the static IP address, that is 192.168.0.2, MAC address is 255.255.255.0, default gateway is 192.168.0.1. And DNS server, so it is a main server machine, so it will take same IP address as a server address, that is 192.168.0.1. Gateway is nothing but main door of the internet, so we need to specify if we establish the router or server, then we need to give the default gateway because main entrance through the internet. So we have set here default gateway as 192.168.0.1. So after making the settings of the configuration of server, now let's move the configuration of machine. So desktop, second machine, we set the address, specify the subnet mask, then default gateway we need to set 0.1 and DNS server is 0.2. So we need to obtain the IP address of server as a DNS server to each machine. So in the same way, we can assign the IP addresses for PC1 in IP configuration setup, it is having 04 unique IP address. Then next PC2, it is 05, and PC3, it is nothing but 06. So default gateway and DNS server is having the same for all the desktop. After assigning the IP configurations to all the devices, so moving the next part. Starting the simulation mode, in that edit the filters of protocols, that is we take the HTTP, SMTP, TCP and FTP. TCP IP is another layer in a computer network which is used for transmitting and receiving data through the internet. So various protocols are used under this TCP IP protocols. But the basic protocols are nothing but SMTP, HTTP and FTP. FTP is a file transfer protocol which is used for local machines for transmitting the data from one machine to another. HTTP is nothing but hypertext transfer protocol. It is basically used to transmit and receive the data over the internet. And SMTP, simple mail transfer protocol, is also used for transmitting and receiving the data. The basic primary difference between TCP/IP and OSI layer, the TCP/IP is only work on the the TCP/IP is work on the 5 layers, but OSI is the 7 layer because 2 layers are transport and session layers are not specified in a TCP/IP. So first 2 layers, data link layer and physical layer, are made connected. Host to host network layer is connected to network, and remaining 3 layers in TCP/IP is connected to direct link. So after making the connection establishment between all the PCs through the servers, the next setup we need to set, that is nothing but first choose on the PC 0 and go to the web browser, because first machine is considered as a HTTP transferring protocol. So in web browser we need to specify the address of URL of web server, that is nothing but http://192.168.0.2. So just we need to click on go button and minimize it. So the packets arises in a PC0, that is called as HTTP, second is called as FTP. Click on that, go to the command prompt and type FTP, and now address of DNS server, that is nothing but server IP address 192.168.0.2. Enter. Just again here packets are receiving, then second is called as DNS. Again go to the command prompt. After giving the setup, just minimizes all the windows, do not close the windows. Give the command ns lookup, specify the address 192.168.0.2. ns lookup, then specify the DNS server name sitcoe@edu.in. Just make the minimization, go to the last machine and go to the email, because it is work for SMTP. Compose send mail to abc@sitcoe.edu.in. Say hi, hello, how are you message needs to be sent. Just click on send button and just minimize. After that, start auto capture play. It will getting started. It will receiving the messages, transfer to the server, getting the acknowledgement and transfer. So PC0 can receive the HTTP protocol. Now PC3, server 0, PC1 is received the FTP protocol now, because here simultaneously packets are transferring to the switch and then server, because TCP/IP is basically work to transmit and receive the packets through the route of internet connection through the server. So basically TCP/IP is basically work on the protocols of HTTP and SMTP and FTP. Now click on this SMTP. Here OSI model and outliers are showing their total levels. Inbound, click on the inbound PDU details. So here TCP tables can show the sequence number, acknowledgement number, source port, destination ports. After receiving the acknowledgement, he will receive the acknowledgement number and the sequence number. So it will showing all the protocols, same for SMTP also. inbound details. He will show the inbound details of TCP table, and outbound details also show the TCP table. Destination port is 1025, source port is 25 in outbound, and in inbound this is the destination and source port. This is also showing the HTTP fast Ethernet. It is showing the sequence number and acknowledgement number, source destination and source port and destination ports, and it is showing the HTTP's connection mode, how many content length, content type, and HTTP data. He will show all the details in the HTTP table, in TCP table. In IP table, it will show the destination address and source address. And Ethernet will show the MAC address of source and destinations. Thank you.